Hi, everybody. Michael Shermer here. I'm the publisher of Skeptic magazine and a columnist for Scientific American. And my new book is called Skeptic. And it's subtitled Viewing the World with a Rational Eye, which is the reading line of my column. And the book is a collection of my best essays from my Scientific American column. Well, the most dangerous pseudoscientific beliefs that people hold are the ones that have public, political, or personal implications. So, for example, do vaccines cause autism? Wow, okay. So, I mean, this has been a hot-button issue for almost 20 years now. Based on one study that was thoroughly debunked and then retracted, and then the guy who did it was banned from doing that kind of science, his medical license taken away, and considered, this whole thing was considered to be fraudulent. And still, this topic is relevant because it means that parents are not getting their kids vaccinated because they're afraid that it might cause some harm. And of course, the only way their kids can be safe is if everyone else in the classroom, when they send them off to school, get vaccinated, because we have this thing called herd immunity. You have to have about 90 to 95% of a population vaccinated in order to prevent a disease from spreading. So if you're one of the few, the 5% that are not vaccinated, you really depend on the whole herd being vaccinated to protect you. So the tipping point would be if you fall below 90, 85% or so, then communicable diseases can spread, and they have been because of this crazy idea, this complete nonsense, this total pseudoscience. So that one in particular bothers me. Evolution and creationism is a perennial because it affects public school science education. And as readers of Scientific American, anybody knows that pays attention, we're way down on the pecking order. The last time I checked, we're like 23rd in the world, behind Turkey, something in terms of science education. It's pathetic. It's embarrassing. I mean, and why is that? Well, it's because you have people like creationists saying that, science is in conflict with our biblical religious views, and this should be taught instead of that, and so on, and it's interfering with science education. So that I go for. I don't worry about the Flat Earth Society. The one guy who was the head of it died. That's it. There's no more members. Flat Earthers, not worried about them. But the creationists, want to affect curriculum in public schools. That makes a difference. So we're going to come out swinging on that one. So those are the cancer quackeries. There's a lot of so-called cures for cancer that turn out to be quackery. People fall for those. Psychics that are helping you get over your grieving of your lost loved one because you can talk to them in a studio somewhere. I mean, this is crazy. So anytime somebody is harmed personally, or society is affected, education, politics, these sorts of things. Obviously, terrorism. We need a lot of work on the science of terrorism. Who are these people? What kind? There's different kinds of terrorism. How do they get radicalized? We don't have a lot of science on that. That's going to be a future topic.